Hello everyone. In today's session, we will cover another topic in fixed asset, which is called mass transfer feature. If you go to the fixed asset module and go to the periodic task, so there is an option called mass transfer. So if you click this option, it will open up a dialog box, and it will give you the option like transfer date. So this is as on date on which you are doing a mass transfer. Basically what it will do is basically transfer from one main account and financial dimension combination to another financial dimension combination, or maybe main account also, because there are option for transfer from account to account. So the main account option is also given here. And similarly, business unit, cost center, department, item group, project. So this will be based upon the account structure which you have defined. So this is the target financial dimension provided here. And then you have two options in the action: print a report for the selected assets. So, and then there is a transfer the selected books. So first one is for the preview purpose, so that whatever fixed asset books you are targeting, it will provide you a report about that. And the other one is the actual action. So before doing any actual action, you need to preview the results. So that's why a report is also provided. So below that, you will have the criteria, target criteria, which will basically be selected, and based upon that, the financial dimension for the books will be changed. It will be changed not only in the books, but it will also be changed in the, for example, trial balance. So whatever value is there, it will also be shifted to the target main account and financial dimensions. So we'll do a test, and before test, I will just show you a few of the fixed asset. So you can go to the fixed asset form here or fixed asset page. And for example, we'll see this computer, notebook, PC. And for this, we'll go to the books. Okay, in the books, you will find this in Contoso data. There are multiple books assigned. So based upon that book, you will find financial dimension provided against the books. So this is the business unit available, management consulting practice, and number is 003. For the SLSL and for this 150 SL, and here there is no financial dimension linked. So now we need to transfer this one from business unit 3 to business unit. We will select any other value, and we'll see how this affects. Also, if you go to the trial balance, I will just show you. I have created another financial dimension set for this, because here business unit, cost center, department, item group, and project are five financial dimensions in the books. So based upon this, I will just show you. If you can go to the general ledger, okay, in the general ledger collapse all, go to the chart of accounts, then you can go to the dimensions. In the dimensions, there is an option available, financial dimension sets. So this will allow you to select any of the combination, the main account plus the financial dimension, in order to initialize the balance. And then you can see the same in trial balance based upon these combinations. So I have created this one, and for this you can just create new and then select any of the option on the left hand side from the available financial dimensions, including the main account. You can select and click this button, it will go to on the right hand side. So whatever sequence you follow, so the same sequence will be on the right hand side box. So based upon this, then there is an option here, like initially it will be initialize balances. Later on, once there is an existing financial dimension set, so there will be rebuild balances or update balances. So once you initialize balances, so the same financial dimension set will be available in trial balance. So I will just go to the trial balance now. From the inquiries and reports, go to the trial balance. Okay, so the year from and to date need to be selected, And from the financial dimension set, the whatever the dimension set you have created an initialized balance for will be available here. If you have not initialized balance, it will not be shown here. So it's better to initialize and then come here, and you will find a financial dimension set, and you can again click calculate balances. It will show you as per the business unit, department, cost center, item group and project wise, which are basically available in this book. So on the basis of that, you can see the trial balance here on the right hand side. For this, the debit and credits are equal, so the closing balance is zero. So this one is 003, the business unit which we are about to change, and this one is 003, which is the actual, and here there is some closing balance. So once we change it, so it will be shifted. Similarly, I will just put a filter here, then it will be more clear. Okay, so now on the right hand side, you can see there are two rows which are without any balances. So I will put here a non-zero value is not equal to zero. So it will show the other values. Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll shift the business unit from here to any other business unit for the trial purpose. And in actual, in the business, if you want to shift the financial dimension or main account from one to another one, so this option is available for that. And also it will change in the base actual book. Okay, so we'll just now go here and we'll put the filter criteria first of all. So go to this filter criteria, reset anything to the beginning, and you can in the fixed asset book derived table, you can select the field, and all the financial dimension in the books are available. So you can just increase for the readability, increase the width of a column. Here you can see the business unit is available. I will select the 003 and we'll shift to the, for example, this IT consulting practice. So we'll select 003, which is the source criteria. Okay, so this is now the criteria, and these books will be picked up. So first of all, I will show you the preview option, print a report of the selected assets. So it will show the, and I need to just unselect the batch. It will just print the whatever it has selected from the books. Okay, so this is the target assets or target asset books. I will duplicate, and now okay, so the criteria is already there, and I will just select transfer the selected books to the target business unit. So this will be 004 IT consulting practices. I'm not interested in cost center, but if you want, you can also select any of other financial dimensions which are available for you based upon the account structure. So you can select any of the department, cost center, but keep in mind that only one target combination can be selected here. So if there are multiple from the source criteria, if you are having multiple assets in multiple business unit, for example, multiple department, but for the target it will be only one which you can define here. If you leave it as a blank, so the blank value will be set. So for now, I am only setting the business unit, and maybe I can also select a department, which is IT department here. Okay, so I will just select these two values, and if you want, you can provide here a transfer comments like transfer of fixed asset value. Okay, and the reason you can also put here, and transfer date is 1st of January 2023, which I am putting. From this date onwards, it will be in these main account or financial dimension. So main account also I can select from here if you want to further narrow down the criteria. but I am not using any of the accounts here, so just only financial dimensions. So I will select the batch processing option. Okay, and click OK. So the batch job has been added to the batch queue. I will go to the system admin. Okay, in the system admin batch jobs, I will see which one is basically executing now. So this is my transfer details which is being executed. I will just keep refreshing until it is finished. Okay, so it has completed. I will again check here. Transfer contains. There are so many and all are ended. There is with no error. I can put a criteria like error. So there is no with error. So it means the job has completed. Now what I need to do is from the books. So this was 003. I will just refresh here. You can check here. The business unit has been changed to the 004, which was our target business unit, and department 025, that is IT department. And you can also check this other one, and it is also changed. Or if you want, you can change. You can also check in any other asset. Okay, so here also it is, the value is changed. So for the trial balance, so now what is the change here in the trial balance? I will again calculate balance here. Okay, so now on the left hand side, we can check here 004 is available with the same values which were earlier on 003. And if you go to 003, on the right hand side you can see the closing balance has become zero. So debit and credits are equal, so the closing balance is zero, so it means it has been shifted. Although it will be showing in trial balance because of transaction as of 1st of January, and our criteria here is also including 1st of January, but the net is zero for 003, and it has been shifted to business unit 004, that is IT consulting. So all the balances in trial balance are also shifted, not only there but also in the books. The values for the financial dimension has been changed. So in this way we have learned how to transfer the value of fixed asset from one main account plus the financial dimension combination to another main account plus financial dimensions. And criteria, we can define whatever the fields are available in the fixed asset master table and fixed asset book table. So whatever the criteria you will select, so you can preview before you can change anything, and you can preview also the value, and then you can execute the actual action. So in this way we have learned in this video how to shift the value of fixed asset, how to transfer the value of fixed asset from one main account in financial dimension to another main account in financial dimension. I hope this would be an informative for you, whoever are working in fixed asset module. And thank you very much. Take care. Bye bye.